Good morning, students. Welcome to BSc 1 Zoology class. So, in the previous video, we discussed the general characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. Today, we are going to study the classification of phylum Platyhelminthes. So, the phylum Platyhelminthes has been divided into three classes such as Turbellaria, Trematoda and Cystoda. These are the three classes of Platyhelminthes phylum. Turbellaria, the term is derived from Greek language. In Greek language, Turbella means a little string. So second class 2, Trematoda. In Greek language, trematos meaning is having pores. In class 3 is Cystoda. In Greek language, kestos means girdle, idos form, girdle like worms, flat worms. Okay, so depending upon their shape, they have been classified into three classes. Let us discuss with first class of phylum Platyhelminthes. Class 1 Turbellaria. General characteristics: mostly free living flat worms. They are free living flatworms. They are not parasitic forms. Mostly they are free living forms. But some ectocommensals, endocommensals and parasitic forms also occur. Ectocommensal, endocommensal. Commensal, cooperative. Cooperative means they may not harm the host in a significant way. So they are living along with their parasites, hosts. They do not harm much to their hosts. Ectocommensals, endocommensals, or they may lead parasitic life. You know what is parasitic life? They live in the expenditure of its host. Okay. Then body is unsegmented, not segmented. Segmentation is not yet started. Segmentation of the body starts from phylum Annelida onwards. But here the worm is not segmented. It is unsegmented. Here. You can see, very rare this one, the body is not segmented, it's very bit long leaf like structure, dorsoventrally flattened, no segmentation, no partition, no occurrence of subunits. Such type of body organization is not there in flatworms. Body is unsegmented. Sense organs, of course. Sense organs are there. We already discussed in the general characters of phylum Platyhelminthes. Sense organs. Which sense organs are there? Tangoreceptors are present. In free living forms, eye spots are there. The planaria is free living. It's free living form. So it has eye spots. Parasitic forms may have tangoreceptors and chemoreceptors. Tangoreceptors means these are the receptors which receive sense of touch and pressure. Whereas chemoreceptors receive the sense of chemicals. Then mostly hermaphrodites. They are mostly hermaphrodites. Hermaphrodites means bisexual. Bisexual, both male as well as female sex organs occur in the same worm. So such animals are called hermaphrodites. So these are hermaphrodites. Body covered with a cellular or syncytial epidermis. Cellular in case of free living. Syncytial in case of parasitic forms. Syncytial epidermis with what do you mean by syncytial? The epidermal cells have more than one nucleus. Syncytial epidermis with mucus cells. Epidermis may have mucus cells, mucus secreting cells. Therefore, their surface is slippery because of the secretion of mucus-like secretion. Mucus cells, which is partly ciliated. The epidermis is ciliated. Here, the planarial epidermis is ciliated, partly ciliated. With the help of cilia, the animal can creep, crawl over the surface of substratum. By using the mucus secretions, it slips over the surface of substratum. Okay, next, adhesive organs abundantly present. Fixing organs to a substratum are abundantly occurring. Secretions, gelatinous secretions, then hooks, suckers, they may present. Then digestive system consists of mouth, pharynx. Mouth is there, pharynx is there, and intestine. No anus. Here, this planaria has mouth on its ventral surface. Pharynx is there, intestine is there, but intestine is not opening through anus. Anus is lacking here. Only one opening is there in the alimentary canal, that is the mouth. So same opening is used for intake of food as well as the ejection of undigested food material. Okay. Next, excretory system. Excretory system consists of protonephridia, the flame cells. So we already discussed when we were talking about general characteristics of platelminthes. In phylum platelminthes, the excretory structures, the protonephridia are seen. They are also known as flame cells. Why they are referred as flame cells? They have cilia, bunch of cilia. These cilia flicker, they vibrate. This vibration resembles the flickering of flame. Therefore, they are referred as flame cells. So, flame cells are nothing but excretory structures present in platelminthes. They are involved in excretion of nitrogenous waste from the body to the exterior. Okay? So, excretory system is developed. It is being developing. Okay? Whereas in the earlier phylum, we have not seen the excretory system. The excretory system starts from this phylum onwards. Means the platelminthes has organ system, organ level of body organization. Okay? Whereas in cylindrates, tissue level of body organization was present. In platelminthes, organ level of body organization. Okay. Next, reproduction, sexual, asexual, and by regeneration. Since these are hermaphrodites, they show sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction may be either through cross-fertilization or self-fertilization. Here, it is cross-fertilization. In the cystoda, tapeworms, self-fertilization occurs. Here it is cross-fertilization. Though the worms are bisexual, hermaphrodites, they are unable to show the cell fertilization. They show cross fertilization. Means for fertilization, they have to have one more worm for showing sexual reproduction. Okay? So asexual reproduction also occurs. Asexual reproduction is by the segmentation of worm. If the planarian body is cut into pieces, each piece develops into, develops into an entire worm, entire animal. This is how by fragmentation asexual reproduction occurs. Asexual reproduction may occur in platelminthes. Okay? Regeneration. Yes, power of regeneration is well established in phylum platelminthes. So what do you mean by power of regeneration? Power of regeneration means if an animal loses some parts of its body, again they regenerate the lost parts, lost organs. That is called as power of regeneration, regeneration capacity. If our hand is cut, if we are able to develop our cut organ, hand, this would be referred as regeneration. That is not possible in higher animals, but in lower animals it is possible. In platelminthes, if its body is cut into pieces, each piece develops its lost parts. That is called power of regeneration. Okay, so power of regeneration can also be in sometimes referred as asexual reproduction, because here the body, if you cut into pieces, each piece will develop into new individual. That is called asexual reproduction. That asexual reproduction is because of power of regeneration. Clear? So these are the methods of reproduction in platelminthes. Life cycle is simple. In Turbellaria class, life cycle is simple. Simple, complex. Complex means if it completes its life cycle in several hosts, that would be referred as complex life cycle. But here in Turbellaria, their life cycle is simple. Simple means they complete their life cycle because they are free living forms. They may not depend on host. If at all they depend on host, they depend on single host. Thus, their life cycle is simple compared with other classes. Okay, let us see the example for this class. Planaria convoluta. Planaria is a very good, well studied example. Planaria leads free living life. It's not a parasitic form. It's not a parasitic platform, flatworm. It is attached to stones, rocks. Under surface of the rock, they are attached, adhered. So they feed on small creatures. Okay, it is leaf like, flattened. Interior end is having the eye spores. Dorsal surface, ventral surface. On the ventral surface, you can see two openings, mouth and molar bore. Through the mouth, pharynx may get averted for capturing food organisms. Okay, with the help of cilia and mucus secretion, it slips over the surface of substratum. Okay, so it leaves free life. It's not a parasitic form. Okay, let us discuss the next class, Trematoda, class 2. Let us start with the second class of phylum platelminthes. Class 2, Trematoda. Having pores. These platelms have pores on their body. So ectoparasitic or endoparasitic form worms, commonly called flukes. They are parasites, no doubt. They are either ectoparasitic or endoparasitic. They may live outside the body of host animal or inside the body of host animal. And they are commonly called as flukes. They are referred as flukes, liver fluke. Okay? They are generally referred as flukes. Then, body shape usually leaf-like, dorsoventrally flattened. Leaf-like and dorsoventrally flattened. For example, liver fluke. Liver fluke. So here, the body is leaf-like, dorsoventrally flattened. Dorsoventrally flattened. Okay? Then, body wall without epidermis and cilia. Without epidermis and cilia. Body wall has no epidermis or cilia, but it is covered by cuticle. Cuticle is a thick cuticle protective layer which protects the parasitic animal from its host secretions. From its host defense mechanism. Body undivided and covered with cuticle. This body is undivided. It is undivided, covered by cuticle, covered with cuticle. Sorry. Well developed suckers usually present. Well developed suckers are there. Look here. Mouth is present at the center of the anterior end and it is surrounded by sucker, oral sucker. This is called oral sucker, and one more sucker is present on its ventral surface called acetabulum, with the help of which the animal can adhere to its host body. So, adhesive organs these are. Suckers are usually present. The digestive tract, incomplete, consisting of mouth, pharynx, and two forked or many branched intestine, anus is absent. See, mouth is there. This is pharynx, intestine. Intestine has two branches, fork-like branch, and they are further branched into lobe-like structures. Okay, this is intestine. Entire body is accommodated by intestine. It has no anus. Protonephridial excretory system consisting of flame cells. As I told you, excretory system is developed. Flame cells are present. These are the flame cells. Protonephridial or solenocyte. This cell has nucleus. Their cavity is present in the center. This cavity has cilia, a bunch of cilia. These cilia move. Their movement looks like the flickering movement of the flame. Therefore, they are called flame cells. Okay? Flame cells are there. They are mostly hermaphrodite. Bisexual. Ovary is single. Testis, two or many. Okay? So, comparatively, ovary number is less than the testis. Their life history, simple or complicated. Life history is either simple or complicated. Okay. Then, example, facial hepatica, schistosoma. This the diagram of faciola hepatica. Liver fluke, sheep liver fluke. It is present inside the bile duct of sheep. Bile, you know, bile is secreted from the liver. Therefore, it is also called as liver fluke. It feeds on bile, which is being secreted by the liver. So, this is about the general characters and examples of two classes of phylum, plant animals. So, in the next video, we shall discuss details regarding one more class of phylum Platyhelminthes. Thank you.